Light is extremely important to plant growth. Light is the energy source for photosynthesis. Therefore, any reduction or change in the amount or quality of light will potentially cause a change in plant growth. We have a video about what light is. The link is in the description. That video goes into the various wavelengths of light and what happens as light comes in contact with the surface. Plants are green because they reflect green light. The action spectrum of plants occurs in the blues and the reds. Photosynthetic active radiation is what drives photosynthesis and is in the orange to red spectrum. Let's think about the plant. There are layers upon layers of leaves. Each leaf is filtering light as the light tries to go through. Here we represent what happens to light as it reaches the plant. The light can be either transmitted, absorbed, or reflected. In this first leaf, the light that is absorbed is converted by chloroplasts into ATP. Reflected light goes back into the environment. Transmitted light will pass through the leaf to the leaf below. How much photosynthesis the leaf below will do depends on the amount of light that it can absorb. There is an interesting publication in the journal Hort Science about how much light can be transmitted. They use several LEDs at unique wavelengths. The amount of light emitted by the LEDs was determined. They then placed single leaves on top of the diodes to see how much light was transmitted. In general, the working range of photosynthesis, only about 2 to 8% of the light was transmitted. We are going to use the midpoint of 5%. This means that of the light that reached the top of the first leaf, only 5% or 0.05 of that light was transmitted. That light hitting the leaf below would then transmit only about 5% of the light. This would be 0.25% or 0.0025 of the light that was in the original sunlight. The leaf below that, leaf surface number 3, would then transmit only 5% of the intercepted light. This would amount to 0.0125% or 0.000125 of the original light. As you go down, there is less and less light reaching the leaves because it is being filtered out by things on top of it. This leaves less light for the leaf below. In general terms, this would be about the equivalence of a brightly lit room. Compare that to the light striking the first leaf, which would be direct sunlight. This is a simplified explanation about what happens when light passes through several layers of leaf. Think about sitting under a tree. It is shady. The temperature is lower. Most of the light is reflected in, not transmitted down. Photosynthetic active radiation really takes in how much light is being absorbed in one leaf on top of another. This causes a difference between what we call sun leaves and shade leaves. Sun leaves are those that are exposed to direct sunlight. They tend to be smaller and thicker. They also have a thicker cuticle. Sun leaves may have a lighter color as they do not need as much chlorophyll to make lots of photosynthate. These pictures are the cross-section of leaves. The pinkish region on top is the cuticle. This is a boundary that helps protect the leaf from desiccation, especially when they are subjected to intense sunlight. This heart-shaped leaf is quite shiny due to the cuticle and waxes that are on the outside of the leaf. This other leaf is dull due to the type of wax that is on the surface. The wax helps protect the leaf from desiccation. Both of these are examples of sun leaves. Shade leaves are thinner and have more chloroplasts. This tends to give them a darker color. They also tend to be large in size as well as having reduced cuticle. These differences are in direct response to the environmental condition of light intensity. This is an example of a shade leaf. The cuticle and wax layers are reduced, giving it a dull coloration. This set of leaves is also a shade leaf called poison ivy. The leaves are soft and supple, without shine. Remember, leaflets 3 let it be. Do not touch poison ivy. Both are shade leaves. Therefore, the concept of photosynthetic active radiation is important to understand how light affects what leaves do and how they function.